Assalamu alaikum. This is the first session of Unplugged on our journey to Ghana. I'm actually in Dubai at the moment. I've just enjoyed some lovely ice cream, mashallah, here. And it's amazing. There's a little bit left, mashallah. So I'll be joining Sheikh Wael Ibrahim and Dr. Muhammad Salah, and inshallah, among others, we are going to Ghana, going to be in Accra. We have the Peace and Unity Convention. And then we want to go to Kumasi, which is another area in Ghana. The idea is actually to empower people. You know, we have so many people struggling across the globe with so many different types of things. And sometimes they become hopeless. They pray, they call out to Allah and so on. But some people don't realize that, you know, it's part of the plan of Allah that we will go through dips, challenges, so many other things. We shouldn't give up. So the idea of the peace and unity is a few things. Number one is inner peace, outer peace, peace within oneself, peace within the family, peace within the community, a peace in the nation, and then on earth, humanity. And the term unity is not uniformity. The idea is to learn to tolerate and respect others. That's all. And I know that on earth at the moment there are some ideas that people have that might be ridiculous, but end of the day we talk about it, we may challenge it respectfully, we may disagree with it respectfully as well, but it should not create chaos in the sense that violence and hitting each other and killing each other, that is wrong, that is absolutely unacceptable. So the idea of this peace and unity is to be able to promote the true teachings of the Deen of Allah, and to be able to bring people together even with differences that we may have, and learn to appreciate why we need to build on earth and not destroy, why we need to be positive and not negative, and so on. So that's the peace and unity. Here's the ice cream, mashallah. Really good ice cream. I know before they had different brands. This one here is absolutely amazing. The brothers brought me some tea. Zakalahi, that's water. Thank you so much, my beloved brother. Shukran, I really appreciate it. Shukran, shukran. Can I ask one favor? Okay, it's fine. I have sugar. No. Okay, you put it? Thank you. Zakalahi, shukran. So that's the water that we have. I think it's EVN water, alhamdulillah. This brother, because a lot of the people recognize me and so on, he was offering to make me some tea. So he asked me, what type of tea do you want? I said, put some milk in it, and here goes. It's a bit of a karak. It's looking amazing. It's looking interesting. I only have one sugar in my tea. And I think soon I'd like to cut that sugar too. I'm becoming sweeter and sweeter, inshallah. Don't you think? But that is besides the point. The truth of the matter is, you know, when you're traveling on a journey, it's not a good idea to eat too much, especially on a plane, and even when you're in transit. Some people eat a lot. It's not healthy. I think for me, with altitude, I'd rather have a belly that's relatively empty. I'd rather drink a little bit more, keep yourself hydrated, stretch often, and inshallah, in that way, succeed. Look at the ice cream, mashallah. A little bit left in here. Amazing. You must be thinking, ice cream and tea. Well, I'm going to wait. I don't like very hot tea, but I like it as it's cooling. Alhamdulillah. So I pray that the journey goes well, and I'll get back to you with more, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum.